to.
I mean, how do you think, like, I don't know, the doubles metagame would completely change if Fountain was one of the stages?
I mean, teams like Double Peach would probably be stronger.
Yeah.
Just because the only, like, really small stage in play right now is Yoshi's.
Yeah.
And if you're playing versus, like, a team like Double Peach, you're always going to ban Yoshi's. So if Fountain was legal, you'd ban Yoshi's and then go Fountain and be eating down smashes anyway. So it could be interesting like that.
All right. Looks like they're going FD.
So when they played before, Ryobeat stayed Peach the whole, or Fox the whole time. But it looks like they're going to do Peach Falcon.
I'm trying to think of like some 20XX pun, but for like peaches, you know? That's what we're seeing.
It's okay, we don't need more 20XX puns.
Right.
we got enough.
Right. See, what do you got? Smuckers was about to get a ton of mileage off that and then completely fell apart. He's trying to make up for it, right? And I that's the thing, I think having Falcon with like a bunch of floaties, you can get a lot of mileage on FD, right?
Yeah.
As long as you're like
the down throw, the throw combos tend to work for longer, so platforms tech on.
As long as you keep track of percentages, right? You can get some. I don't know if you'd be able to get like early stocks, but you definitely forced to.
That's the wrong situation. Peach will live the knee, yeah. 80, 90.
Yeah.
You're gonna need to be like at least 100 first you're gonna die, or just yeah. There's actually something I feel is not talked about in teams. It's actually way harder to keep track of percentages in teams.
Mm-hmm.
So like, if you don't, because like obviously in this game, if you don't know what percent they're at, you don't know which follow up you're gonna use like until you hit them.
I don't know, this is not looking very clean from the moment. I think that's two SDs so far this game.
I missed them.
Yeah, so. I mean, of course, could the green team, you know, even the odds? Of course. Something like that definitely helps, right?
Yeah. Alright, so they wait out the invisibility. That's gotta hurt if you're green team. takes a turn up. Says, take it back. I don't want it.
No, this is it. Wow, okay. That was a nearly clean edge guard. That was nearly clean.
Yeah. So Ryobeat keeps getting sandwiched in between these two peaches. It's the worst spot to be in, because they can do stuff like that.
Yeah. I still don't think FD was like... Actually, who got the stage pick? Was it green team?
I'm not sure who had the choice between the two.
Yeah. Either way, I don't think FD is bad for green team. I just think they kind of screwed it up quite a bit this game, right? Like,
I think it really just comes down to the position. Red team is doing a really good job of just staying together.
Like, I mean, we just saw six... Yeah, I was counting. Six knees by Smuckers, you know? It's like he's getting desperate. You can see it.
I don't know if it's getting desperate. I think it's actually a really good option. It's full happening, especially on FD. Because if you hit use a shield with it, it's safe, pretty much. See, like, he tried to shield grab, but he covered it with a jab. And, like, when both the Peaches are at kill percent, it's actually really good. Like, after, like, two knees, it might shield stab.
That was a really
great tech. This is pretty much it. Normally I believe in the comeback, but
yeah, I don't know.
163.
A peach taking on three peach stocks is... yeah.
This character's the trade master.
It's like raining turnips or whatever.
Yeah, you want to take over for me? Wait, I'm trying to take break. Pass the mic off to Chomsky.
This is fun!
That was good commentating.
For sure. I'll see you out there. What's up? Oh, yeah. were we that bad?
I mean... Me and Subtle couldn't save the stream, so you get to watch three Peaches and one Falcon.
Yeah.
I think the problem was I didn't shine enough.
I mean, there's no such thing as too much shining, so definitely, you know.
Yep. All right, let's see. Maybe raw red.
Okay, so I don't know. Green team counterpicked to Battlefield. What do you think of that?
I think it's good. I think platforms against Nature are amazing because they don't have very much vertical movement, so it's hard to catch. Like Smucker can just go top platform when he's waiting for his teammates. Stages like Stadium and FD and Yoshi's even are like kind of rough on Smuckers because they catch him out a little bit more.
So one thing I'm noticing in green team is that they're just making too many mistakes, right?
Like that?
Yeah. Like Ryo accidentally SD'd earlier, and then of course you're seeing Smuckers SD too.
I mean, that's true.
And I mean, last game was like three SDs as well.
Oh, jeez.
You really can't do that.
Maybe they're rattled.
Yeah. Which is unfortunate because they were playing so well earlier.
Nice.
But I guess
they're up now.
Yeah. Freaking melee, you know, like, percentages and stocks don't matter, right? Like, it's like the last 10 seconds of basketball.
Specifically in teams.
Yeah.
Especially in teams, actually. Like, it's like, damn, you got caught out. Oh, Smuckers, you're nuts. He wanted the, like, the weird gimp.
So, in that situation where Peach is, like, neutraling on the ground doing her little spin move, right, and he's being blundered around, what's the best way to DI out of that, or best way to handle that?
If your shield gets caught, you shield DI it out, okay. And for Fox and most characters, you can short hop in aerial to interrupt it.
Okay.
Or if you're, like, a grab-heavy character like Marv for Peach, or Marv for Icy can, like, shield DI it out and then wave that in, jab-grab. Or Marv can just wait until it's over, like, with the shield DI out, and then wave dash in and grab. Those are, like, probably the best ways for grab-heavy characters. Characters like Fox and Falco, they can, after the shield DI out, they can short hop there and get some percent going.
Okay, so there are a lot of options.
Yeah. Down smash isn't that great. I mean, it has amazing startup frame data, of course.
Right.
But, like, if they just do it and they don't catch anything, it's worse in singles. In teams, it's a little bit harder to deal with because, like, they have a teammate ready to save them if they get hit. See, like, they had, Rog was above maybe for down smashing and was covering space if they were trying to come into punish.
So,
let's see. I mean, Smuckers is at zero.
Yeah, I know. That's surprising.
They're both at like combo percent, these both pieces. I think Smuckers can really do it.
Yeah,
yep, there you go.
Oh
my god.
Still living. Yeah, you really cannot get combos.
Wow.
He squeezed that out. He totally squeezed that out. And I don't know if he was able to bait.
Smuckers can do this. I really believe. Oh. This is a super bad position.
Yeah.
All right. We're good. That was nervous. I always get nervous when Kyle gets off stage.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, I don't. I get nervous.
Right.
There it goes.
They clutched that out. They
input clutch. Input error. I mean, like, why would you spot dodge? That was kind of a weird spot dodge.
Still, very impressive clutch out considering, for all intents and purposes, they were playing pretty sloppy right now.
I mean, they definitely cleaned it up a little bit. I think, like, they were still, they were more used to the Fox-Sheik matchup instead of Peach. So, like, because you gotta play those so differently. With this one, there's a lot of full hopping going around, a lot of, like not micro-spacing either, like, big, like, you gotta, it isn't even just spacing. With Fox-Sheik, it's, like, there's more short hopping and, like, more movement involved. And this one, like, Falcon can't really run around that much, like, dash hands, because Peach just has such huge hitboxes that cover so much space, so it's harder for Falcon to move.
Yeah, I think another thing for Falcon is he's going against two floaties, you know, he has to put in a lot more work.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think that much more. I think it's harder to get in. Yeah, I think it's... I don't know. I think it's easier than Fox Falcon. I think it's easier for Falcon. But Falcon 2 Peach is a different sort of Falcon Peach. Because, like, that can happen.
Yeah.
Peach has an amazing edge guarding game as well. Ryobeat's holding on to these two. Alright, never mind.
Okay, so red team is slightly ahead by stock.
I mean, they could very well much easily get these two stocks. Two knees, and that's it.
Yeah, there it is.
One. See if we can get the second one.
It was close though. It was like we definitely saw what they were trying to set up.
I have no idea how Ryobeat died. Smuckers is at a high percent. Oh, he tried to do some jinky, like a star jump or something. A star jump knee or something. Alright, cleaned up that stock. This was a red team's counter break, so.
Yeah.
I think it might have been a smart decision. Smuckers doesn't get a lot of room to run around. But like, the only negative is they die early, but
yeah,
what does that matter if they get killed early as well?
I mean, the thing with Smuckers that I've never said is, I mean, of course, all Falcons are very aggressive, right? But,
not all. His playstyle is aggressive, specifically. Yeah. Yeah. It's a lot of movement and mix-ups in his movement, I think. I don't know that for sure, because I don't really watch his gameplay a lot or play with him that often, but, like, that's what I felt like when I played doubles. Like, he was always trying to, like, mix it up. And that's really important as a character like Falcon, who doesn't have, like, a lot of, like, quick options, like, high-priority options. You know what I mean?
Right.
Ooh. If they can get this Peach.
Yeah, I don't know. They didn't capitalize on that 2v1.
I think Smuckers should have just gone in and grabbed, but he could have aired out of shield. So it's like, it's kind of like 50-50. Not a 50-50, but it's like risk reward. And it's like getting nared out of shield at 80, like really that, just to get a grab. I don't know. I mean, they should clean this up.
Yeah. But this is going to be a bad place for red teams if they aren't able to clutch this out. And there it is.
Let's go, Smuckers.
This is fun!
Shoutouts to our stream IT man, the silent hero.
So I'm still pretty new to New York. I'm still learning all the people and.
Oh, you're new to Nebs?
Yeah. I think this is my second Nebs.
Welcome aboard, dude.
Thanks. Yeah, I am. I'm actually a journalist for ESPN. I cover esports for them.
That's sick.
So it's good to come out to weeklies and keep yourself fresh.
In with the crowd, you know, get to know the people.
Yeah,
it makes it easier for you too.
Yeah.
Did you enter as well?
You know, I'm thinking about it. Since I just moved here, I haven't bought myself a CRT and I haven't been practicing at all.
Okay.
So I know I'm gonna get 2-0 like the first game. It's just gonna happen.
It happens. I mean, like,
but, you know, I might just, like, support, you know, just for fun, right?
Yeah.
Support the tripod or whatever.
I used to do that with PM, but then, like, it kind of, like, they moved the dates at my locals from Mail and PM were different days. Let's see what happens here.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I'm from Houston, right? So Houston has a pretty decent PM scene.
Yeah. I know about it. Like, I just know it's, like, a strong region for PM.
Yeah.
I don't really know much players.
Although from speaking to kids in you know, that used to have PM clubs in high schools and whatnot, they've slowly been switching back to melee, which is really unfortunate for, I guess, the PM crowd. And we can talk about PM, right? Like, we won't get in trouble. I think we're on Hitbox, right? So shout out to Hitbox for sure.
Let's go, Hitbox. All right, let's see what's happening. I kind of lost track. So far, it looks like the Peach is adjusted, and I don't know what they did.
Oh, okay, that was a lot of fun.
Hello, chat. Ryobeat was the toast. Oh, he had to hit that turnip or else he would have gotten just, like, gimped.
Ooh. I think Smuckers has something. There
Smuckers
he is.
Yes. Smucking it up.
That was delicious.
That was impressive.
That was like peanut butter and jelly goodness right there. Okay.
Is it bad that I already want Ryobeat and Smuckers to win? I just don't want to watch Peach beat again.
You know what I do like about Six Smuckers play? He definitely likes playing. He wall jumps really well. He wall jumps quite
well.
You just don't see enough wall jumping from Falcon sometimes. It really. Especially on a stage like this, it can mix up your recovery options. I'm surprised I killed off the top.
It's a really strong play, and Yoshi's low ceiling really helps to it.
Yeah. Okay, so I don't know. I mean, can Ryo clutch this out? I don't know. It looks like they're just gonna play.
Oh, this is
grab ass with turn up, right?
Help me. This is awful. Ooh.
See, oh.
It might be,
Yeah, right, he's trying.
I mean, like, he's just strong, so, like, I don't see this being impossible, but it's but just, I, like, I, gonna I, take so much patience and, like...
They're respecting Ryo way too much, right?
I mean, because I think one, like, good hit in air would, like, just kill him.
Yeah.
At least, for... Is that maybe?
There it is.
There it is. I think Pokemon... Pokemon... Where was game one? Do you remember?
It was FD, right?
Okay, so they're gonna... So, I don't think they want to go to FD. So, they have Pokemon Dreamland, and I think they're going to go Pokemon. Either Pokemon or Battlefield. I think Smuckers might want to go Battlefield, but... All right. I figured Pokemon, to be honest.
So, we're at Game 5. Pretty high Blues' final so far.
Definitely. Definitely not a place you want to be. I think he needs to buffer roll more after the jab. Like, buffer with the C-stick to get out of that. Because, I think he's been caught in that position, like, more than once.
So, like, the box in Pokemon Stadium, right? It's low ceiling, but it's really wide, right?
Yep. It's like wide as FD, but it's like one of the lowest... It's the second lowest stage in the game.
Yeah. I'm trying to see... Yeah, so I guess it just gives a lot more survivability for Peach, because it can just float aerially from side to side.
It does, actually. Yeah. Now that I think about it, it's probably... I don't think this is that good of a counter pick, because Falcon isn't really going to kill off the top. He's going to kill off the side more often. So I think Battlefield would have been better, in my opinion, but I don't know.
Right.
There's a reason why I'm not in loser semifinals.
You know, I think with Battlefield, it would give Spuckers a lot of room to...
Yeah, that's him. Oh, actually, he is a movement-heavy Falcon, so, like, it does help him be able to, like, just move around and, like, get in more.
I think one thing I've noticed in the blitz is that they are not taking advantage of the 2v1s. I mean, they'll take advantage of it when it's just, like, one player left, right? But,
Yeah, of course.
I mean, you got to look at, like, I don't know, how DJ and Moon do it. They totally apply the pressure. I mean, for all intents and purposes, it's still very even.
It's still even. Oh, that might be it.
Yeah.
He just won't save him.
Yeah, poor Falcon, man. Poor Falcon.
Definitely. I wonder if singles are up yet. They're in the corner. They need to get out of there. They have center stage. They're boxing them out. This is really good.
So that was a beautiful knee.
It always is. The Smuggler's really good. There we go.
So I think, like... So I know in singles, obviously, like, neutral middle stage control is very, very important, right? Is it just as important in doubles?
I think it's more important in doubles because, look, there's two people, like, edgeguarding you at once instead of just one, like, in singles. So, like, having that stage control and being able to, like, force two people into, like, one area is really good.
So I think what I'm noticing is that I'm seeing red team seed a lot of their positioning way too early, just kind of go after one edge. I mean, it's a difficult back and forth, a difficult 50-50. Do we hold our ground or do we go out?
That's a nice game. Yeah.
Right now they're giving Smuggler a lot of room.
Yeah.
And I think that's dangerous.
I mean, that's just because Peach is slow and can't really get at Falcon. Ooh, there's the circle song.
Even again.
Like, look how fast Falcon can just run away.
Yeah, exactly. It's the fastest running speed in the game, right?
Yep, that's why stage control is really important, especially against Falcon.
Yeah.
Because he can just clear room so quickly. Like, he's just gonna haul ass over there.
Can you play Falcon at all? Are you any good at Falcon?
I mess around with Falcon as, like, for fun.
I mean, every time I, like, pick up Falcon, I'm like, what is this? What is going on? Who designed this? Why Sakurai?
So,
I mean, it's very difficult. Major respect to Falcon players.
Yeah. I think the only thing, like, pushing me away from Falcon to main them is his recovery. Like, that recovery's so bad. Back throw? Oh, mash out. Good mash out by maybe over here.
So I think green team is definitely taking it slow. Do you think it's safe for them to just apply the pressure and just clean it out?
I think playing it slow is. I was gonna say playing it slow is the best option because you don't want to get hit by any stray hits.
Yeah, that's true.
And like just Smuckers was at 100, so.